We're gonna get into the details of what's happening with Intel's desktop CPUs in just a minute, but first I wanna make something very clear. This is not a sponsored video. This is not sponsored by Intel. This is not paid for by Intel. This is all part of our investigation that we've been doing, and this is the result. Now, here's the deal. We do have a very good relationship with Intel, and because of that, they were kind enough to share some helpful information, AKA the press release, in advance so we could release this video in tandem with the press release as soon as it came out today. With that in mind, our goal with this video is to address the issues people are experiencing with the 13th and 14th gen Intel processors, and ultimately to provide a path forward for those of you affected, as well as to test if you are one of the folks who may be affected by this instability issue. At a high level, we'll cover what you can do right now to protect your system if it's currently stable, how to check for stability issues if you aren't sure, and what to do if your 13th or 14th gen Intel processor has actually already been impacted. Now, if you want a full in-depth technical deep dive on what's been happening with some of these Intel processors, you can take a look at Wendell of Level 1 Tech's video from July 10th, where he digs deeper into the technicalities of what's happening and what we're gonna go through today. But here's the TLDR of what's going on. Many people using 13th and 14th gen Intel CPUs, mainly 13900K, KF, KS, and 14700K, K, KS, and KF, have been experiencing stability issues. This includes some system integrators and game devs as well. As we have said before, people like Wendell and in an ongoing way, Steve from Gamers Nexus have done thorough research to dig into the issue, as has our team. Today, we have an official statement from Intel acknowledging the issue and outlining exactly what's causing it. Now, we're gonna throw the statement up on the screen, so feel free to pause the video if you wanna read it in more detail. We're not gonna read it in full, but here are the takeaways. Number one, Intel acknowledges the problem. The elevated operating voltage is stemming from a microcode algorithm causing the incorrect voltage requested to the processor, which has resulted in potential instability with Intel CPUs, in some cases causing permanent CPU damage. Number two, Intel will be releasing a microcode patch mid-August that will address the root cause of the issue and prevent these issues moving forward. In the meantime though, there is already a motherboard BIOS update out, which fixes previously requested things from Intel, including another just released microcode update available, which can help mitigate stability concerns until a full fix is available, which takes us to the very important third point. Finally, and very importantly, CPUs have a lot of different things that can be tweaked by motherboard manufacturers. Voltages, wattages, resistances, and more are all things that motherboard makers have altered and adjusted to differentiate themselves from the competition. Unfortunately, and without your consent, they have pushed these aspects outside of Intel's default for both power and, more importantly, for safety, which has caused instability and can cause damage. Over the past few months, Intel has been working with motherboard manufacturers to rein them back in and ensure that they're staying within Intel's default and are safe for your CPUs, plus ensuring that any overclocking is off by default and only turned on if consented by you and that you understand the risks. So if you're on an Intel 13th or 14th gen CPU, what do you do with this information? Well, let's start with some good news. There is something that you could and should do today to protect yourself against any further CPU instability or damage, especially if you're not currently experiencing any issues. By should, I mean, I recommend that you must do this now to help protect your chips while we wait for the root fix. Intel has been issuing guidance on their forums of how to get these motherboard power settings back into Intel specifications for the past few months. But not all of these fixes were user accessible, and frankly, it's a pain in the rear to find and change all of those. Now the BIOSes that include all these fixes as default should be available for your Intel Z700 and Z600 chipset motherboards. But before you rush off this video, let me explain. Not just any BIOS update will do. You heard the term microcode earlier in this video already. It is absolutely vital that you get the BIOS updates, that it has the specific microcode update. You can see this highlighted in the video right here. This will help put your CPU operations back within Intel's power and safety defaults. Again, you want to ensure that the BIOS you are grabbing has this particular update, and you may also want to bookmark your motherboard support page to check it regularly for the most current code updates. If it happens that you have updated your motherboard in the past 3 months, some adjustments to these voltage issues and things that motherboard manufacturers are fixing to stop these algorithm boosting games have been rolled out already, which should have reduced your risk for any issues. And if an earlier update without the specific microcode we mentioned earlier is all you have available to update, given the lag for your particular board, you should still do it to reduce risk. If your brand new motherboard doesn't have an update within the past few weeks, updating to whatever the latest version is should still reduce the risk to your CPU. Also, even if you did recently update, check for updates anyway. There's been new versions that dropped within the past few days, and if this microcode update is part of that, then you need to do it. At the time of getting ready to record this video, we know of new updates for Z600 and Z700 series motherboards. And again, we want you to see this microcode when you go to update. This will help get your CPU back into Intel's power safeguard specifications while we wait for the root fix in August. Just to be clear, you could still see some impact on performance, close to a 4% loss. Now, a lot of the problems we're seeing have created a 4% jump in CPU performance from motherboard manufacturers trying to differentiate themselves while simultaneously calling for and receiving more power than they actually should for the chip. So yes, your PC may run up to 4% slower, but it's not crashing. And with this update, it's requiring for you to opt in on any overclocking done to your CPU, which is critical and safer for your CPU. Now, in case you're wondering about whether it matters if a B series or W series motherboard, the answer is yes. And you need to get the latest BIOS upgrade if you're gonna be using one of these CPUs. And if you're saying to yourself, Robey, the W series boards that Wendell mentioned and the B series motherboards don't overclock and do all that funky stuff. Well, funny enough, they actually do. And we actually talked to Wendell about this. Not only did he confirm that both of these have some of those settings, but they're also enabled by default, not just in the old BIOS settings, but in the new ones as well. In fact, according to him, his clients using server hardware like W series motherboards are still running into stability issues, even with the regular BIOS and microcode updates, because they need this new fix Intel is rolling out in August. Now let's just have him explain it.
Okay, just a new CPU has been installed, 13700T. And that's on 3603, which is current as of yesterday, but there's a new version today. All right, first boot on our July 18th, 2024. BIOS on the W680 IPMI. Before making adjustments in the BIOS, 3701, 13700T. Asus Advanced OC is on. Performance Enhancement 3.0 is on. This is off in every data center configuration I've looked at, but this is apparently the default. Let's go to load optimized defaults. Yeah.
Said W680 motherboards were more conservative, not that they were perfect. And yes, they have BIOS updates, and yes, you need those BIOS updates. They contain fixes from the manufacturer as well as Intel's new microcode. Yes, it's a team effort to get this resolved and to try to prevent new people from experiencing this problem. Even if you're not experiencing problems now, this will be a good step toward a preventative measure, preventative maintenance, if you want to file it under that. You definitely want to do this because, yeah, BIOS update. It's a good idea.
Now, there's still more work to be done on the professional boards, and if you want more details on that, you should check out Wendell's tweet about the W680 boards and the power specifications going through those chips. But for the chips, specifically consumer boards, the Z600 and Z700s were the first to be worked on, and they should have all of Intel's required fixes in place now. Again, I cannot stress this enough. If you're using a modern 13th or 14th gen CPU and associated motherboard, just update the BIOS. You really are risking your system by not doing it. It's not a silver bullet solution, and it won't necessarily solve the whole problem until the final update, but it will keep things from getting worse and improve the situation. Okay, so you've updated your BIOS with the microcode update and you're waiting for the root fix in August. Now what? Well, if you haven't been experiencing any stability issues and you want to identify if you have an affected CPU, this is one of the best ways I've learned to see if your system might have an issue. Now, it's not 100% guaranteed that it'll work, but it provides an environment that an affected CPU is most likely to fail within. One slight hitch, though, is that you will need to be running an NVIDIA GeForce card to test this, sorry. Essentially, you want to go download the entire driver package from NVIDIA's website for your GPU. There is a ton of decompression happening here that seems to trigger the same instability if it exists, much like the Rad Tools OODL decompression error. Now again, before you do this, you need to update your BIOS with the microcode update and make sure you are up to date. Have I stressed that enough? I think it might be important, guys. If you don't, this could also cause an issue, and there's no reason to test for instability if you aren't running within Intel's default specs and safety guards. Okay, once you've done this, then go ahead and install the NVIDIA drivers a number of times over. Like, 5 times should be enough to trigger it, but 10 times to really be sure. Now, if you see this error, then you may actually have the CPU issue. Try this several times, and if it fails, first you need to reboot, because if you don't, subsequent installs will more than likely fail. But regardless, it may be time to go ahead and call Intel customer support to talk about a replacement. Now, for the Radeon folks, or for folks who are just looking for that peace of mind, running 10 minutes of Cinebench a few times may also actually trigger the issue, but it's nowhere near as consistently. Unfortunately, if you do all these installs with no errors, it doesn't mean you're 100% in the clear for instability issues, but the odds are definitely in your favor. Now, What happens even after the new BIOS updates, you're still experiencing instability? What's your path forward? Unfortunately, until the final August microcode patch from Intel arrives, the last resort fix to get your system back to stables is to downclock it by about 300 megahertz. You do this by decreasing the clock multiplier, which just slows your CPU down a bit. Then, if Intel's final microcode update in August won't get it back to full stability and speed, we recommend reaching out to Intel support to see about getting a replacement, which we have to say, we really do appreciate that Intel is doing this and we have this option. Now, I know this means downtime for your rig, which in some cases can be costly if you use your PC for work, but it's probably going to be your best road forward to ensure you have a functioning CPU, especially if you have the latest BIOS updates and fixes, so this will not happen again after you install your new CPU. Now, if you just purchased a 13th or 14th gen CPU or an Intel-based system from an SI like Falcon Northwest or iBuyPower or CyberPower, should you be concerned? Again, we'd recommend using your BIOS and making sure it's up to date. And trust me, the SIs are all working very closely with Intel to ensure that it actually is. In some cases, like that of Falcon Northwest, we're seeing almost zero failure rates now and much more stable systems with a lot of the larger SIs that we've spoken to with part of our investigation. So based on all the information we have and the data we have gathered from all the SIs we've talked to, the odds of you having an issue are significantly reduced if you're unaffected by the instability already, since they reverted things back to the world of stable and safe before sending them out. Now, we definitely recommend paying attention to any communication from your SI as we get closer to August, as they may contact you when the patch to repair the issue becomes available. Let's be clear, this whole situation has not been awesome, but we're seeing some clear signs of resolution, and it looks like Intel wants to make things right for all of those who are affected. Not only do we know now what we can do to stem the impact on our CPUs, we also have some way forward for people whose machines have been crippled by instability. With Intel's response to the issue, their close work with motherboard manufacturers, and their stated commitment to customer support, we're hopeful that these issues get resolved quickly so that people can just get back to enjoying their PCs without fear. So the TLDR here, grab your latest BIOS update with the correct microcode adjustments and keep an eye out for the full fix in August. These two things will give you the best chance to ensure instability doesn't become a regular part of your gaming or your workflow. And if you're still impacted after that, call Intel and work with them to get you a new CPU. Hopefully, this video has been helpful and hopefully it has saved your CPU and you've listened to the advice we've been giving you. As we close things out here, we wanna say this. We don't regularly do videos like this very often, but this was way too important not to talk about and way too important not to tell you to go do right now. And we wanna give a huge shout out to Wendell for chatting with us about his experience and for helping us with this video and the script and everything else. And also to the folks at Falcon Northwest who have been critical in helping us get this out, as well as the many unnamed sources who've been instrumental in making sure that this was as accurate and helpful as possible. I also wanna give a huge thank you to Intel, mainly because as we did our investigation, they brought us behind the closed doors, gave us the information we needed to do so we could be part of the solution and helping you get your CPU fixed and giving you the right insight on what you need to absolutely do now. As always, we appreciate your time and we look forward to seeing you on the next video.